A team of researchers, including ones from Stanford and Google, have created and observed a new phase of matter, popularly known as a time crystal. There is a huge global effort to engineer a computer capable of harnessing the power of quantum physics to carry out computations of unprecedented complexity. While formidable technological obstacles still stand in the way of creating such a quantum computer, today's early prototypes are still capable of remarkable feats. For example, the creation of a new phase of matter called a time crystal. Just as a crystal's structure repeats in space, a time crystal repeats in time, and importantly, does so infinitely and without any further input of energy, like a clock that runs forever without any batteries. The quest to realize this phase of matter has been a long-standing challenge in theory and experiment, one that has now finally come to realization. In research published in the journal Nature, a team of scientists from Stanford University, Google Quantum AI, the Max Planck Institute for Physics of Complex Systems, and Oxford University detailed their creation of a time crystal using Google's Sycamore quantum computing hardware. For the research team, the excitement of their achievement lies not only in creating a new phase of matter, but in opening up opportunities to explore new regimes in their field of condensed matter physics, which studies the novel phenomena and properties brought about by the collective interactions of many objects in a system. Such interactions can be far richer than the properties of the individual objects. The researchers were able to confirm their claim of a true time crystal thanks to special capabilities of the quantum computer. Although the finite size and the coherence time of the imperfect quantum device meant that their experiment was limited in size and duration, so that the time crystal oscillations could only be observed for a few hundred cycles rather than indefinitely, the researchers devised various protocols for assessing the stability of their creation. These included running the simulation forward and backward in time and scaling its size. A key signature of an ideal time crystal is that it shows indefinite oscillations from all states. Verifying this robustness to choice of states was a key experimental challenge, and the researchers devised a protocol to probe over a million states of their time crystal in just a single run of the machine, requiring mere milliseconds of runtime. This is like viewing a physical crystal from many angles to verify its repetitive structure. Creating a new phase of matter is unquestionably exciting on a fundamental level. In addition, the fact that these researchers were able to do so points to the increasing usefulness of quantum computers for applications other than computing. A time crystal may sound like it is from the pages of a science fiction novel, but it is something that the researchers have demonstrated is possible to observe, even though it may appear to go against the basic laws of nature. You might be familiar with crystals like emerald, diamond, and salt. At the microscopic level, they are made up of repeating patterns, many layers of atoms that ultimately form a physical structure. For example, a grain of salt is made up of sodium and chlorine atoms. A time crystal is similar, but instead of forming a repetitive pattern in space, an oscillating pattern is formed in time. To give an example for time crystal, let's say you took pictures of a planet and its orbiting moon every time it finishes its orbit over a period of time with a Hubble telescope. These pictures would all look the same, with the moon repeating its orbit over and over again. Now, hypothetically, let's say there were hundreds of new moons added to the planet's orbit. Each new moon introduced would exert gravitational pull on the orbits of the others. Over time, the moons would start to deviate from their orbits without ever coming back to their starting point. This increase in disorder or entropy is unavoidable due to the second law of thermodynamics, a fundamental law of physics. What if there was a system of a planet and many moons where the moons could periodically repeat their orbits without ever increasing entropy? This configuration, evidently hard to achieve, would be considered a time crystal. Let us see how the researchers use a quantum processor to observe a time crystal. Quantum objects behave like waves, similar to how sonar uses sound waves reflected from solid objects on the ocean floor to detect them. If the medium that the quantum wave travels through contains multiple objects at random locations in space, then the wave could be confined and come to a complete stop. This key insight about quantum waves is what puts a cap on the spread of entropy and allows the production of a stable time crystal, even though it appears to be at odds with the second law of thermodynamics. This is where Google's quantum processor comes in. In the research paper, the researchers describe how they used Google's Sycamore processor as a quantum system to observe these oscillatory wave patterns of stable time crystals. Observing a time crystal shows how quantum processors can be used to study novel physical phenomena that have puzzled scientists for years. Moving from theory to actual observation is a critical leap and is the foundation for any scientific discovery. Research like this opens the door to many more experiments, not only in physics, but hopefully inspiring future quantum applications in many other fields.